There's a common question asked in every analytics group these days, and it's how can I import my universal analytics data into GA4? Unfortunately, the answer is that you can't. UA and GA4 use completely different data models, and importing isn't possible. This confusion probably resulted from the language that Google used to describe the move from UA to GA4. Phrases like migrate from UA to GA4. Migration does imply moving data, so it's no wonder that people have questions about how to move data from UA to GA4. Since you can't move your data, what can you do instead? In this video, I'll walk you through exactly how to blend UA and GA4 data together in Looker Studio so you can present your metrics in one graph combined between the two properties. Now, an important note before we get started. Common metrics like users and sessions are measured differently in GA4 and Universal Analytics. Your data will not match perfectly between the two, so it might be misleading to combine the two into a single graph. Please make sure to watch our video on 8 key differences between UA and GA4 for more information. The first thing to do in Looker Studio is to add both data sources to a report. You can see here I already have Universal Analytics and GA4 added to this report. If you don't know how to add data sources to a report, I recommend going to the description of this video and reading our post. It walks you through exactly how to do that. Before I blend any data together, I like to display the data I'm going to blend in separate tables. Then I can be sure our blend is working as it should. Here on the left, we have Universal Analytics. That's the table that's just Universal Analytics. Then I have a table here for GA4 sessions. To blend these, I'm going to select both of them, just right-click and drag. Then I'm going to right-click again and choose Blend Data. Now, here's my blended data. I can see it kind of layers it on top. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this over to a different page to work with it. Now, here we are with our blended data. It's showing us a date in sessions, but which sessions is it giving us? Let's fix this up. Over here in the data source, you can see it's named Blended Data 1. We should rename this too. We're going to click this little pencil icon here to open up the blend. Now, depending upon which chart you selected first, you might see GA4 on the left instead of on the right in this example. It doesn't actually matter which source is on the left and on the right. The first thing I'm going to do is rename the dimensions metrics. Otherwise, I won't know what's coming from UA and what's coming from GA4 in our blended data set. To rename a metric, just hover over the metric until you see this little pencil icon. Click that and then put the new name in. We'll name this UA date. We'll name this UA sessions. We'll name this GA4 date and we'll name this GA4 sessions. Then we want to make sure to rename our data source as well because blended data 1 isn't very descriptive. Now that those things are renamed, I also need to change how the data is blended. By default, we've ended up with what's called a left outer join. This returns everything from whichever data source is on the left and anything from the right data source that matches what's on the left. But since your UA data did stop collecting data at some point, and your GA4 account likely hasn't been set up for very long, you're going to end up with problems where not all the data will blend together because of this left outer join limitation. Instead, you're going to change this to a full outer join. This brings in all data from both sources. So I just clicked on this blend condition to change it, and then double check here to make sure your join conditions are still good. We're joining the two dates between UA and GA4. This all looks great. We're going to click Save, and then we're going to click Save again. Then we're going to click Close to get out of here. Now let's make this larger, and then we're going to add in all of our dimensions and metrics that we just created. We have UA date already, we're going to add GA4 date, and then for metrics we had UA sessions already, so we're going to add in GA4 sessions. Now you can see that we have all the data here, but for GA4 dates where it was before GA4 existed for this client, we actually have these dashes. This is blank or null data. If I scroll down, now we can see, oh, you know what, on March 28th, we had both UA and GA4. And if I keep scrolling down the data, eventually I'm going to find a point where UA also didn't exist. You can see here, now we just have GA4 and no UA. What I actually need is a cutoff where I only use the GA4 data after a certain date, and then I use UA data before that date. For this client, their UA data collection didn't actually shut off until July 24th, 2023, but we're going to switch the data over on the actual sunset date, July 1st, 2023. In order to tell Looker Studio when to stop reporting UA sessions and instead start reporting on GA4 sessions, I'll need to use calculated fields. There's two calculated fields you're going to create. The first calculated field will be a dimension for the date. We're going to click this plus symbol here next to add dimension. Then we're going to click create field. And then enter a name for the new dimension. I'm going to call this coalesced date because that's what we're doing. Then in the formula box, paste in this formula. You can find this formula in the description of the video. Then click apply. Now you can see we have the coalesce state showing up. And what is coalesce doing? Coalesce is taking the first non-null value. You can see here we don't have any UA dates, we have GA4 dates, so it's picking the GA4 date. If I scroll up to when we had UA dates, it is picking whatever is non-null. In this case, both dates exist, so it's just picking a date. You'll see it more effectively when we get into combining UA and GA4 sessions. The next custom field we're going to create is for sessions. We're going to click Add Metric, then we're going to click Create Field, and we're going to name this Blended Sessions. Now, in the formula box, we're going to paste in this code. Again, you can find this in the description of this video. And then I'm going to click Apply, and now we have our Blended Sessions column. Now you can see that in the cases where, say, only GA4 exists, it's pulling the GA4 date. But then if we go to a much earlier date, say before the cutoff that we decided, if I go back to say April 2nd, you can see it's actually choosing the UA sessions data instead of the GA4 sessions data, even though GA4 did exist on that time. Now, what the heck is this formula doing? There's several different functions being used here. There's case, there's cast, there's format date time, and coalesce again. This is instructing Looker Studio which metric to use based on the date. The cast function is used to turn every date into a number. That way I can set a cutoff date and then instruct Looker Studio to use different data based on dates being larger or smaller than that cutoff date value. The format date time function takes the year, month, date and formats it exactly like this, 2023-06-30. And then this case function is being used to help Looker Studio make a decision what data to return based on this date number. Our cutoff date is anything bigger after June 30th, 2023. That's the number 2023-06-30. The date July 1st, 2023 would translate into 2023-07-01. That's larger, so it's using GA4 sessions, the then part of this case statement. If the date is June 29th, 2023, that changes into 2023-06-29, which is smaller than the 30th date. So then UA sessions is used, the else part of this case function. If you wanted a different cutoff date, the only thing you would need to do is change this number here. For example, if you wanted to change the cutoff to March 15th, 2023, you would just change this 2023-06-30 to say 2023-03-15 instead. Really simple, just have to change that one thing. Now, obviously a table is not the best way to display this data. So instead we're gonna use a time series chart. The first thing we're going to do is remove the extra data that we don't need. We're gonna remove UA date and GA4 date and remove UA sessions and GA4 sessions. Now with the table still selected, choose this chart dropdown and then we're gonna pick time series chart. Now you have a single unbroken line seamlessly transitioning from UA to GA4. We can even add in a comparison to a previous period or previous year even though this client didn't have GA4 set up last year. To do this, find this default date range section under the setup part, then click this dropdown, and then here you can choose what you wanna show. In this case, we're gonna show previous year. And now you can see that we have blended sessions and then blended sessions of the previous year. And what's really interesting, you can see these weird spikes here in Universal Analytics. This is the kind of spam that used to sneak through UA's filters. Hopefully we shouldn't have that happen in GA4 because it does have better spam protection. Now, what if you just want to show this data for organic search, for example, instead of absolutely everything? To do this, we're going to add in filters to our blended data source. Now, if you need to still show all sessions and organic sessions at the same time, you don't want to modify the blended source we've just created. Instead, we're going to create a new source. We're going to go into Resource, Manage, Blends, and then we'll find the one that we're using, and then we're going to click Duplicate. Now we have our copy, and then we can edit this copy. So in this copy, first thing we're gonna do is rename this. I've renamed this to say just organic sessions, so it's clear that this is what this blend is being used for. And then we're gonna add in filters. You can see here for UA, we're gonna click Add Filter, and then we're going to click Create a Filter, and then we're going to name this UA Organic Sessions. Then for the include, we're gonna choose the default channel grouping that is equal to organic search. Now we're gonna add a filter for GA4. So we're gonna click Add a Filter. We already have this ready. But what this filter is doing, I'll click the pencil icon so I can show you, it's pulling in the session default channel group equal to organic search. And hit back. And then I've got my data source renamed. I have my filters applied to both UA and GA4, so I'm gonna hit save. And then what we're going to do is we're actually going to change the data source of this chart to use that new organic sessions. And now you can see the data showing organic sessions instead of all sessions. So this is a really easy way to filter down this data. We use this quite a lot with different client reports. We'll have different filters for things like organic search, paid search, etc. Just make sure to create different blends for each type of filter that you want to create, so you're not accidentally removing a filter on something that's actually in use. And that's it. Now you have a single unbroken line combining UA and GA4 and can compare to previous years, even if GA4 didn't exist on the client site. Do you still have more questions? Check out our other videos to get more answers and leave a comment letting us know what topics you want us to cover in future videos. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.